dress on your wrist, a plain Jane.
What up and welcome back. It's your girl Jane, the plainest Jane, and we got some syrup to get into. So I got some updates when it comes to the health of Von, how he's doing in the hospital. His mom was able to visit him. I want to talk about that encounter between the mom and Marvon. But also, if you follow the backup channel, you know that the father was also able to visit Marvon, despite the fact that the wife, Dre McCray, Andrea McCray, is trying to do everything in her power to stop Von's parents from visiting him or even getting any updates about the well-being or the life of their child. So I want to get into some life updates. You know, I went over the police report in my initial report, but I want to go back over some things that we might have missed in that police report. And then also there's some information about the children of Andrea McCray. Let's get into some potential custody battle in the near future that may have already started via court filing. So yeah, let's get into this stuff. Make sure y'all hit thumbs up. Y'all already know what time it is. When you're getting on my bus, hit the thumbs up button. It's free to donate some support to this channel. You ain't gotta spend no money. And let's get into this syrup.
The plainest Jane. This is one of my favorite comments here. She says, I loves me some black, and she said, loves me some black news. She says, is it just me, or does anyone else get tired of seeing people that don't look like them delivering info about them day in and day out?
So if you're not quite up to speed, this is a story about a black man in a coma, Von McCray, and his wife, Andrea McCray, aka Dre McCray, and all the suspicious circumstances that surround it. Why is it suspicious, do you ask? Well, just take a look at her behavior while her husband is behind her fighting for his life on a ventilator.
I promise I won't be. I need to get your mouth, baby.
Yesterday, I put my saliva on him. Show did. I went all up in my and put it on him, on the top of his head, on his neck, and on his arm. Saliva carries information. And I want him, I can't touch him physically, but my saliva is gonna go through his body and it's gonna tell him, I'm here, I want you, wake up. I want to spit in his hands. Okay, here we go. I'll talk to his nose. I love my outfit that I'm wearing. Can someone take a screenshot? Okay.
Not to mention, she feels like she's his doctor, she's his healer, she can treat the seizures that Von McCray has at home with herbs, some saliva, and some drugs that she's admitted to smuggling from Mexico.
Also used to treat my husband's seizures. I'm treating him naturally. I'm his doctor.
I don't want to take my car into Mexico. I'm gonna have to call my friend, but of course I'm gonna take him somewhere else. We're gonna go home. We're gonna try to get some rest. I'm probably gonna go to Mexico first, get some pain meds, because I don't have anything for him.
Yeah, so trying to get something like that is very hard. The medicine that I have now, I smuggled from Mexico. Like, it's not even something that smuggled from Mexico.
I was so mad. And then I remembered what happened the last time that I got mad. I acted on it and I made him have a seizure. I acted on it and I made him have a seizure.
So the illegal herb that she uses, again, it is just like an opioid, just about, and it's also very similar to heroin and other drugs that are ridiculously difficult to wean yourself off of. There's a high probability of you being prone to falling into the habit of addiction when you are using that illegal to even import to the United States, non-FDA approved substance. This substance can also lead to seizures. So how are you treating seizures with something that can lead to seizures? It also can lead to psychosis. Other side effects include hallucinations and delusion, dizziness, drowsiness, depression, breathing suppression. So there are a lot of dangers as it pertains to this herbal substance. And there have been 91 cases of overdose here in the United States for people who use this. Now, it's called kratom, and she also calls it special tea.
So I take the special tea that starts with a K. I'm gonna say it one time, kratom, okay? K-R-A-T-O-M. If you spell it in the comments, it's better to call it special tea.
Now, speaking of special tea, let's zoom back into this police report. So in my initial reporting on Von McCray and Andrea McCray, and if you haven't checked out that video, it'll be linked down below in the description box, the very first link in the description box, and I'll also pin it to the top of the comments. But in my initial reporting, we went over about 5 pages of the police report, right? Now, if we circle back to one of these pages, let's get down to the 4th paragraph of this page, right? It says the last night that Vaughn was conscious, that he was standing up before he fell and had a seizure and then fell into a coma, he and his wife, Dre McCray, they begin to argue when she offered him some tea.
So I take the special tea that starts with a K. I'm gonna say it one time, kratom, okay? K-R-A-T-O-M, special tea.
Now, if we go back up to the 3rd paragraph of this police report, right? It mentions him seeing a therapist, his demeanor changing according to his wife, right? Demeanor changing, him just becoming someone that she didn't know, allegedly, and even becoming verbally abusive, according to his wife's testimony. But let's take a look at this wording of the 3rd paragraph. It says, Andrea McCray stated that her and her husband had been married for 8 years. They have one child in common, but he raised her 2 other children. It says that Von McCray went to a physical therapist. Now, keep in mind, they say physical therapist, right? Von McCray was honorably discharged, right? He's an ex-Marine. Well, I mean, once a Marine, always a Marine, right? But he was honorably discharged due to a leg injury that he sustained while he was serving the country. So he started going to a physical therapist to help him, you know, develop all of the feeling and the walking pattern and all that stuff that he had prior to the injury. Now, again, we get into his wife's testimony. He went to this physical therapist. When he went to the therapist, her husband's demeanor changed and he became someone that he did not know. Again, this is all from the police report, so it's not that it's fact or 100% true. This is just what Drea McCray told the police, okay? She said they always got along until after his therapy, then he will become verbally abusive. Now, they say physical therapist once, and then it's just therapist. And then you can see here, Von McCray finally stopped using the therapist, okay? Now, this is someone who's helping him to learn how to walk again and to gain all of the feeling and the cognitive coordination that they need in order to be able to be healthy again, like physically. So why would he come home and maybe be different after a physical therapist is there to work on his physical body, not his mental body? This could be something, right? Just perhaps, Stickies, think about this for a second. A physical therapist is there to monitor how well you're doing. So this could have something to do with your diet, right? It's very common for you to go to your physical therapist and for them to ask you, what's your diet like? What are you eating? So that they can help assess whether this is helping or hindering the process of your recovery, right? How well you do when you gain back all of your feeling and your motion. And if Von McCray was revealing to this physical therapist all of these herbs and concoctions and the different drugs and all of this, You know, this could be something that the physical therapist was potentially advising Von against. And maybe when he got home and she was offering him, you know, these tea and these things, maybe he realizes that between his physical therapist and himself, he knows that that's just not what's best for his body and his recovery right now. Maybe he's denying it because he doesn't want to take these teas and whatever herbal concoctions and whatever other stuff that she presents to him. Keep in mind, they went on this alkaline vegan diet that includes all of this other stuff in 2019, and that is the same year that Von began having these seizures and his health really took a hit. It declined something serious. So it's just really eerie to me how maybe he's coming back from physical therapy. Maybe he just decides, listen, that's not what's best for my body. That's not what's best for my recovery. I don't want to take that stuff right now. I think that that's very well a possibility. Not to mention, we get to the part in the police report where the argument on the last day that he was actually conscious, they're arguing after she offers him some tea. So I don't know, Sickies, what are your thoughts about this situation and that possibility? Do you think it's plausible or not? Any and all thoughts? Make sure to keep it sticky and real down below in the comments. Now let's get into this next portion of the video where I want to talk about a potential custody battle in the works when it comes to the children of his wife, Drvgs McCray. Rolex on your wrist, a plain giant. Now, if you're up to speed and you've seen all of part one of the breakdown that I did of this situation between Von McCray and Drvgs McCray, you know that I revealed in part one that Drvgs has three children total, two girls, two teenage girls from a previous marriage, and one youngest son that she actually had with Von McCray. Per this court document that I put here on the screen, I've redacted some of the sensitive information, right? But we can see that the father of Drvgs McCray's two girls, he's actually filed for what looks like temporary custody. Now we can see that this is a petition. This is something that is still in effect that actually Drvgs herself filed for in or around about November of 2013. And we can only assume that Drvgs has full custody of her kids, right? Because they're always with her in every video. She's streaming all day, every day, 24/7 in the RV that her and her family live in. As of July 19th, you can see that the respondent, right, to the petition, who is her ex-husband and the father of her two teen girls, he actually filed to modify those orders on July 19th, right? And one can only assume, because it says temporary and Drvgs has custody of the kids, a lot of people are concerned about the well-being of the kid, well-being that Drvgs has admitted that she also feeds
special tea
and other harmful herbs and substances to her children as well. And we've seen her children taking some of these substances on camera. So when it comes to the well-being of the children, it is definitely a concern. And it seems as though the father of her two teen girls, her ex-husband, is actually filing something to get temporary custody at the very least of his children at this time. So let's get into the life updates of Von. I was telling you in the beginning of this video that his mom was actually able to visit him and lay eyes on him and hold his hand and all this other stuff, right? Really exciting stuff for a numerous different reasons that I broke down in part one. The wife of Von McCray is not allowing her husband's parents to see him or have access to any updates when it pertains to his well-being. But despite all of her efforts, mom and dad were both able to visit Marvon. The video of dad and what he had to say visiting Marvon is on the backup channel. But Marvon's mom actually decided to share what happened within the experience when she visited her son Marvon McCray. Now, first and foremost, he's off the ventilator, according to mom, right? Mom also said that when she grabbed her son's hand and she kissed her son's hand, he smiled back at her. She was able to kiss him on his cheek as well, and to get a little bit of what she would call some eye contact from him. He was somewhat responsive, according to what she had to say. She says that when she put her hand inside of his hand, she could feel him trying to squeeze her hand back. So that's good news from the mom. Marvon also was able to hear his mom say, open your eyes. And she says when she instructed her son to open his eyes, you know, she was able to see the whites of his eyes a little bit, a sliver of that. And she says she was able to see his pupil as well. So it's not like he full-blown opened his eyes. The mom is saying that I was able to see the white of his eyes and a little bit of pupil when he heard my voice. So that is a bit of an update when it comes to the health of Marvon off the ventilator. So we're gonna see how this thing goes. You know, a lot of the doctors have been telling Dre McCray that there isn't really a lot of probability of him waking up. In fact, they think that he more than likely will not wake back up, or some of the things that the medical professionals were informing the wife of Marvon Jackson about. So that's some really good news that Marvon's mom was able to share. Now let me shout out the channel where she actually shared this. She did a live interview over there with them. This channel is called Justice4All. I'll link it in the description box. I'll also link it down below in the pinned to the top of the comment section as well, if you just kind of want to hear the full context, her voice, and how she explains it in her own words. But I just gave you a brief summary of what the mom had to say about the progress of her son. But also, while Marvon's mom was over on that channel, she spoke about forgiveness, right? She said when it comes to forgiving the wife of her son, Dre McCray, she said hopefully they can forgive one another and move forward. But she made it clear that they are still at odds behind closed doors. And basically what's happening here is you have Dre McCray, the wife of Von McCray, claiming, hogging, and controlling all the access and all of the rights to her husband Von and his mother's grandchild. The wife, with Dre really holding all of the access and the rights to Von and the grandchild's life, of course Von's mom wants to see and be a part of the decision-making process when it comes to her son and her grandchild. The two are going to continue to clash because it's just this power pull, and it's really disgusting, to be honest. There's a lot of drama mixed up into this man, honestly, who is laid up in a coma, and it's really sad to see. So those were some of the things that were discussed in the video and in the live interview. Again, it'll be linked down below this video, and this was on the Justice4All channel where this took place. Okay, I do implore you to check it out. It is a very long video, so you'll have to, hopefully someone has some timestamps they can leave down below in the comment. But listen, Stickies, I want to hear from you. What are your thoughts about these updates when it comes to Von, his health, the police report? Why do you think they're always arguing about tea? Does he want to have tea? Does he not want to have tea? What could have been the difference? What could have been the reason as to why, when he came back from physical therapy, why do you think he was potentially different? Or do you think he was different at all? And do you think that his wife was making that aspect of the story up all along? So any and all thoughts, I would love to hear from y'all down below in the comments. I just find it very peculiar that when she offered him tea, they got into an argument, and that was the last day that he was conscious and that he was standing up, you know, before he fell into the seizure and then fell into a coma. So there is no shortage of suspicious circumstances surrounding Von McCray and his wife, for sure. Again, she is an admitted psycho. And you know, that clip, along with many other incriminating clips from Dre McCray, they speak volumes. But that's it for this video. Make sure you pay your goddamn fare. Hit the thumbs up button on this video. Also consider subscribing if you haven't already for more Black celebrity news updates and just cultural commentary for us, by us. All right, y'all stay beautiful, Black, and blessed, and I'll catch y'all in the next video. Deuces.
You better believe my behavior is gonna be erratic all the time, boo. This is why I didn't show my husband my crazy until I got married, okay? I trapped him. Mm-hmm, I said it. But now he doesn't look at it being trapped. He is happy that I trapped him, okay? Because he benefits. But yeah, it's not lately. It's all the time, mother sucker. Since I've been on social media, my behavior has been consistent. Psycho as a mother and very passionate with a big heart. But someone that don't take no bull. And so whenever bull...
It was gone.
Let me just go in the bush and weep. Let me just go in the bush and weep. I just have to go in the bush and weep. Really. I don't understand. I swear to God, I don't understand. Hey, roll us
on your wrist, a plain Jane. But that's it. If you want to catch more of my commentary on Black culture or vital and trending information, be sure to subscribe by hitting that little circle in the middle of the screen, or I'll catch you in one of these rectangles to the right in another video. I'll see you there.